Well, if you are just joining us, we have the fabulous Adam Richard, funny man, on our panel today. Your laugh is so infectious.
I'm it's sorry the best about that.
Giggle. No, I love it. You are back in town on a new tour.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm doing a show called Hashtag FGT.
Can you tell us what that stands for?
Or
not
I
in this,
could.
Not in this.
Oh, is it
not
rude?
On television? It's
oh,
rude.
It's sweary.
Yeah, it's basically a homophobic
isn't it for
slur.
For goodness sake.
Oh, of course. Of course
yeah.
Oh,
it could be. I tell people it's yeah, fun gay times.
For good times.
But it's about cyberbullying, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, I'm tired of cyberbullying, so I want people to come to the show so I can do it to them in person. It's exhausting doing it online all the time.
I read somewhere that you said comedy was like sex. How so?
It's that rush. It's like, you know, when you're talking on stage and everyone laughs and you get like a, ooh, this is
really?
Thrilling.
You have an orgasm?
It's, it's not that messy item.
You are terrible.
I don't know what to say.
Yeah. I thought you meant like, you know, comedy is just like sex, it's all over in a minute.
And everyone laughs at you.
That's right.
People frequently laughing. Pointing.
What do you do when people try, you know, and heckle and do all that sort of stuff?
Oh, generally it's fairly easy. Like, you know, it's just talking. but sometimes you get people who are a little bit under the weather and don't understand the put-downs and the quiet. And that's just... You just call for security after a while.
I just don't understand why they're there. Mm. Like, why would you go... Why would you pay money to see someone who is entertaining only to...
Well, they're probably drunk.
I had people making out in the front row a few weeks ago. Like, just heterosexuals kissing. It was disgusting to me.
It does prove your theory that comedy and sex are pretty much the same thing.
I was right.
People say when they're heckling you during a show.
Oh, it depends. Sometimes it's really lovely. People, like, you know, you'll ask a question on stage and people want to answer. Right. Like, you know, you'll bring something up and people are like, oh, yes, I don't like that, Danny Minogue. Like, you know, they say things like that. Or, you know, but sometimes it's just, you know, people shouting horrible things.
Do you ever regret anything you say when you're performing?
I've regretted a lot of stuff I've done in my life. I did celebrity gossip on radio for 10 years. I'm sure I've said many, many things that I don't even remember that people have found.
Has there ever been someone in the audience saying, you know what, that is actually a zinger, you got me?
Like, Oh, yeah. I'm happy to own it.
What's the best line you forgot?
Oh, God, I don't even know. That's I do, like, 7 shows a week, like, for 52 weeks a year. They don't stick in your head. I don't remember how my show goes.
Do you go home and kick, do you go home and kick the cat?
I don't have a cat. I'm allergic.
Oh, dear. I like it. Well, I just thought it must be very stressful making people laugh 7 days a week so you go home and kick the cat.
No, but they're laughing. It's fun. It is so much fun.
What about kicking the cat when you come home?
I like how Adam's response wasn't, you know, oh, no, that would be a terrible thing to do. It's like, oh, no, I don't have a cat. But if I did...
No.
It'd be flying through the air.
No, we wouldn't. No, we love cats.
I don't want to hurt my shoes.
We will put all of Adam's tour dates on our Facebook page and our website. Stick around, because he's here for the rest of the show. Adam Richard, everyone.